I am Sandeep Singh and this is your first chapter, Mapping the Earth. In this lesson, you will learn about what is map and explain what is globe and name various features. And in this lesson, you also learn about identify, explain the different elements of map, compare globe and maps. So let's start now. For 1,000 years, early humans walk across the surface of the earth with just stars to guide them. Student, do you know that in earlier time, when the man who was not familiar with maps or globe, they walked on the earth by the help of stars or sun. However, over time, travelers and explorers started feeling need some tools and would help them find their ways. By this, the men were very difficulties to travel on the earth because there are many faces, their problems like storms, day nights, and many other causes. So they feel that to need their some extra tools to help them journey. Globe and maps were two of most important tools invented for the purpose by earlier geographers. So they made the two tools, globes and maps, and these help to men to travel across the world. So first we look at globe. What is globe? A globe is a spherical representation of the earth. It spins around an axis. What is globe? Globe is a spherical. It means that a round shape, not whole round. It is like an orange, called spherical. It spins around an axis. Globe is spin around its axis, allowing us see different continent and ocean that make up surface of the earth. When we look the globe, we spin around the surface and we observe the whole surface of the earth at once at a time. It shows us features of the earth just where they are without stretching them out of the shape. On the globe, we can observe the whole part of the surface without stretching the map. On the map, we stretch about the whole part of the earth, but on the globe, we can show whole part of the earth at once. However, globes are large and not easy to carry around. Globe is a big object, so we cannot carry anywhere easily. Accurate and well-made globes are also expensive. Big and accurate globes are expensive, so everybody cannot expend their money. So therefore, most people who need locate, place, study part of the earth in detail prefer use a map. So beside the globe, many people prefer the map beside the globe. Now we look at the map. What is map? A map is a representation of the earth or a part of on a flat surface. What is map? Map is a part of the earth on a flat surface. Map is easy to carry around and quick and convenient reference for the people. Map is very easy to study about at once. However, as earth is spherical and map flat, not a part of surface of the earth, there are many differences in globe and map. Like we can locate all the places on the globe, but we cannot locate the small part of the earth or on a map, globe. So we can locate on the every part of the earth on map. Okay, it can shown correctly on map. Some part get stretched up out of shape. Types of maps. What? How many types of map? there are different types of map, some of them shown here. Here is a political map. You can look at the political map. So political map shown the location and boundaries of different countries, some of them also shown state within country. In political map, we can also find the different types of country, different kind countries and their borders and their locations. Okay. Next map is physical map. Physical map shown landform or physical features of the an area such as mountain, river, seas, plains and desert. In other map, we can locate the different types of physical features like rivers, seas, plants, deserts. So it is called the physical map. Road maps shown as road connect places and thus help travel from one place to another. In road map, we can locate the two places to connect the by the road. City map shows as road, street, landmark in city. Next map is thematic map. Focus on certain features and characteristic an area. For example, they may show vegetation, climate and crops grown in area. There are differences between physical map and political map. Thematic map, that is, in political map we locate the different types of country, different countries and their border. In this thematic map, we can locate like climate, rainfall, soils and etc. type. So this is the thematic map. Okay. A map. Every map has certain elements or features. By studying these elements, we are able to gather information about the area being shown in the map. Every map has a special characteristic to understand the map, because what or which type or place located on the map, so we can put a special object on the map and understand that that place is the particular place, either have a particular things. So there are many types of elements. First is title. Title means name. It tells you which area covered by map and what types of map it is. In this, in title yeah, name, that is tell us which types of map is located here. Second, orientation. It means direction. It tells you where is the cardinal direction or on map, most map are drawn with north at top. Every map have a direction that are drawn on the top of the. It has four direction and top of the map is locate the direction is north. Next is symbol and keys. Most map make use symbols. There are many symbols in use. Symbol is a picture or sign used in map represent something from real world. In this map, the symbols used to represent on the map. Colors are also used to symbol. The key or legend explain what each symbol stand for. Every colors or symbol is that every meaning of the map, that is what they are shown. The key or legend explain what each symbol stand for. So key help us interpret, understand the map. Next is scale. It means it is impossible to show real world feature or distance on a map the way truly are. Therefore, maps are always made a specific scale. Student, you have to understand that map has a scale distance between two places on the earth, so it is locate the places. Scale is relationship or between distance on a map and corresponding distance on ground. For example, if a map has scale 1:100, If a map shows that one rational 100, it means 1 centimeter map equal 1 meter. It means that 1 centimeter shows that 1 meter on the ground. If a map has scale 1 rational 1 lakh, it means that 1 centimeter map equal 1 kilometer on ground. It means that if a map has shown 1 centimeter on the distance of map, so it is shows that the 1 kilometer on the ground. Many maps shows the scale as line with distance mark on it. This is called graphic or linear scale. Each division on line represent particular distance on the ground. So thus a map has own language consisting of scale, symbol and colors. We can use map only if we know how to read, understand these elements. Comparing globe and map, what are differences between globes and map? First is, globe is a spherical in shape and truly model of the earth, while a map is a representation of the earth on a flat surface. Okay, a globe shows us features of earth as they really are, while a map often changes shape of feature and land masses. A globe shows us only part of the earth at a time. A map can show us either surface of the earth at a glance. Next is, a globe is difficult to carry around. A map is easy carry around. A globe cannot show features of the earth great deal. A map can show any number of detail depending on scale. So this is your first chapter, and you will learn about globe and map. Okay, goodbye.